Hi friends, Livelihoods are how to supplement is how to conduct LEAP in your village. This month we try to understand about the LEAP, its process and two LEAP tools, social map and resource map. First let us know what is LEAP. LEAP means Livelihoods Enhancement Action Plan. It is one of the method to understand the entire situation of the village. Different types of LEAP tools are used to understand the village situation. These participatory tools help in understanding and analyzing the current reality of the village. The information of LEAP is collected from the community, is thoroughly analyzed to identify the gaps and possibilities for Livelihoods interventions in the area. Participatory current reality assessment of the households, the community, village and surrounding areas combined with the relevant information provides this understanding of the Livelihoods situation. This is triangulated between the tools with the community and combined with the secondary data available. Livelihoods interventions evolve from the understanding of the Livelihoods situation. Suitable and viable action plans for plugging gaps and tapping these opportunities and enhancing the existing Livelihoods then emerge. Before going for LEAP in a village, team has to follow some prerequisites are, facilitator should arrange the trained team and the team has 3 to 4 members. Fixing the dates and plan for LEAP field study. Prepare checklist, formats, material and stationery. Team should collect rangoli powder, rangoli colors for drawing social map on ground. Team has to select the village for doing LEAP activity and also give message to village representative and about field study. In any village, team can do one LEAP. But team can do social map more depends on number of households. One social map for 500 households and if more than 500 households, team do more social map depending number of households. Team has to follow do's and don'ts during field visit. Team has to stay in the village only. So food and accommodation facilities should be done before coming to the village. Team has to know about the village before going to the village for familiar and planning. Team has to follow village norms. Do not give any promises to the villagers. Do not critics on village culture and traditions. Do not comment on local politics and other sensitive issues of the village. To understand the Livelihood scenario of the village, certain tools referred to as indicative LEAP tools are used. Important LEAP tools include social map, resource map, livelihoods analysis, traded in and traded out analysis, incomes and expenditure analysis, value chain analysis, seasonality analysis, 24 hours analysis, 365 days analysis, credit analysis, institutions analysis, vulnerable and vulnerabilities analysis, migration analysis, market analysis, health analysis, education analysis, farming analysis, environment analysis, culture analysis, technology analysis. This is indicative list. More LEAP tools could be added depending on the local context. Before going for LEAP, team has to do some activities. Team has to reach the village one day in advance because to check arrangements and preparations and familiarization. When team reaches the village, team has to meet village president, ward members, village organization leaders, Anganwadi teachers, other important people to tell about LEAP activity and also communicate messages to youth, service providers, village cadre, etc. about the LEAP activity and also ask support for this study. Team members have to distribute their responsibilities. Team should start transect work along with the villagers in the evening for the purpose of familiarization with the village, observing village infrastructure, understanding people's status and living conditions. One facilitator can draw village map. During transect work, facilitators can discuss on housing, roads, water, drainage system and sanitation situation and other issues of the village. Facilitator should note important special things of the village while discussing with the village people during transect work. Conclusion of transect work, team has to tell vote of thanks to who are participated in the transect work and also invite to participation in social map. Team has to conduct meeting with the president, ward members, village organization leaders, Anganwadi teachers, youth and other people to discuss about LEAP study and explain detailed study. Inform about next day's social map activity to main people of the village. Ensure dandora for announcement about social map in the village by dandora person to know village people about social map activity. There is no fixed order in which the LEAP tools are conducted. It is advised that the social map, resource map and livelihoods mapping be done at the beginning. This repetition of information serves as a method of triangulation of the data and helps the facilitators validate the information. During the social map, team has to remember few points. Start social map at morning between 7 to 8 a.m. because at that time people available and also participate in social map activity. Facilitator can start social map activity after ensuring required people arrived. Ensuring the community's participation from different sections of the village. Social map should be drawn on ground using rangoli colors. Social mapping of the village is done with the community for entire locality. Selection of the common place for drawing social map because it should be convenient and accessible for people. It is convenient for drawing social map. During social map, one facilitator should facilitate the community. One facilitator should write minutes. One facilitator should facilitate the community to draw social map. Social map also captures physically infrastructure, institutions, CBOs, housing pattern, drainage system, service providers, temples, draining, water facility, etc. Social map captures the social structure of the village, household details, community-wise details, landless families details, child laborers details, vulnerable groups details, etc. While drawing social map, team has to follow certain rules, which are: first, draw village outline like borders. Start from one direction. It may start from east, west, south or north. Next, draw main roads. After that, draw streetwise. Differentiate house types with different colors. We have to give numbers to households while drawing social map. The facilitator should encourage the community members to volunteer in drawing the social map. Team has to ensure that covering all things of the village. Team has to collect details which are demographic details like population, families, children details. Social composition details like caste, BPL status, poor and poorest of the poor details and housing type details. Infrastructure details, livelihoods details, livestock details. Vulnerable group details, pensions details, CBOs and institutions details. Migration details, schemes details, educational level and skill-based occupations details. Housing pattern of various caste types of houses. Membership in various informal and formal institutions. Leadership in the village. Once completed, facilitators and the community should revise the map. After completion of social map, next day morning team has to do resource map, whose process is similar to that of social map. While drawing resource map, team has to follow certain rules, which are: resource map should start next day morning between 7 to 8 a.m. because people available in the village at that time. Team should use rangoli powder, rangoli colors for drawing resource map on the ground. Resource map also should be drawn on ground. Selection of the common place for drawing because it should be convenient for people. At the time, people are available. Facilitator can start resource map after ensuring required people arrive. Ensuring the community's participation like social map, the resource map is also done in consultation with the community. One facilitator should facilitate to the community. One facilitator should write minutes. One facilitator should draw resource map on notebook or white papers. And one facilitator should facilitate community to draw resource map. First, map village geographical borders in four directions and draw main connecting roads from village to agriculture fields. Resource mapping is the process of plotting the various resources. Cover natural and physical resources of the village. Cover all forest area, irrigation tanks, ponds, lagoons, canals, streams, watersheds and other water bodies, CPRs, etc. Identify land types, crop types and irrigation status. Complete one corner to next corner, then ensure completion of the resource map. Distribution of resources, ownership, access to and use of the resources, seasonality of resources and use, changes in resource use over the years, risk faced and what they did at the time of risk. Once completed, facilitators and the community should revise the map. Social map and resource map should be drawn on the chart separately.
Thank you.